and see if this one works. And it gives... So, like a glove, and we are live, and we're gonna be, I'm gonna just be sharing this one somewhere else, paste, and then I'm gonna start the video, the music rather. Just let me start some music while I do this one. I'm just posting the links and everything to Facebook. Sure, we tag everyone, and then I will be returning to the chat so I can see where people are. I'll just open up this one for now so you can see it. Publish it, see if we have any. Like so, let me make this one like this so I can see it big. And I'll share, share, share. Now feel free to like and share on Facebook as well, and yeah, hopefully someone will pop up and watch it live. Meanwhile, I'm just gonna be talking a little bit about what I'm gonna do today. The idea here is to I started working on this one proper yesterday with the colors and stuff like that, and it's the looks slightly too golden, so I'm gonna need to make it a little bit less golden, a little bit less, a little bit more white. Excuse me. So for that one, I've acquired some items from other people. Yeah, there. Some images from, I think this one is from Leroy Van Fleet. And I have a painting from Robin Ailey, mainly for the white here now, just, you know. And I had one from Phil Hale somewhere. That's for later for the hair. That's for the armor. Yeah, for Phil Hale. White with a yellow tint to it. I want to kind of not have that yellow. This is just some generic stove somewhere. I'm gonna put in the right. Mm-hmm. Now the lighting is coming correctly on this one. So even if it doesn't actually look like this, it has the right shading and everything. So it means we can look at it for references. So if you see this creamy, this is very yellow. And I want to avoid the yellow. Let's see. I'm gonna take away the fill hill on this one. Isn't gonna be helpful at all. So when I started painting this one, I had this fur thingy going on, so we're not gonna have that one because it's too yellow. But the rest of the lighting is kinda good. So let's see. Viewer list. Alright, let's see. So I need to get the white correct. And to do that one, I have a couple of images to help. And we're just gonna basically try out what works. Because it needs to look good, and that's, you know, that's the biggest, that's the most important part. Actually gonna just change that one to color, see what gives. Sometimes when we do overlay, then that one happens. Color dot, yeah, then it gets all. Testing mobile app seems to be working. Let's see. Just gonna lower this one slightly so we have so much. Actually, somewhere there is where I want it to be ish. So let's see if we can do that one from there. Ah, I see. Right. You know, just that one's seemingly a lot easier than I thought it was gonna do. But now I need to fix, move around with it so it becomes slightly more correct when it comes down to the lighting. Right. So I need to add a little bit more of that one. Add another layer on top. This is the benefit of working in digital form is that I can really... I can really, really just put a layer on and try and see what gives. So is how's it working with the mobile app? Is it working well or not? Working crap. One of the negative parts about the move now is before it was very easy to for people to just look and view right away on Facebook, and it is kind of easy now as well, but it looks more complicated. So there's that. Before it was also a lot easier to see when people were watching, you get likes and whatnot, and on Twitch you don't really get likes, so I don't see anything like that. I can see, I can't see any extra people. So there's that. But you know, it's very odd. Quite honest. Shall be adding some. Testing up. Is it working? Is it not working? Just see. Oh well. So that one needs to go up there. Her ears will be here. I'm not gonna have her ear out. Just gonna hang under her. Okay. Better. So I still need to fix this one so that it looks somewhat better. We're gonna browse in bridge. I need to go past stuff again, so I need to move this one. Not the end of the world, but you know. Sorry, I need to sneeze. Excuse me. Yeah, right now, if you're wondering what I'm doing, I'm actually looking for a reference. It's, you know, either a photo or a 3D reference or something that shows how concrete or something similar to concrete would look. I have something here from the order 896, or what is it? I just opened that one. 1886. So this one will tell me how the let's just move this one. It will tell me how the how the graininess looks and stuff on the how the shadows will fall and things like that to make this one look better, to make it look more. So, and thank you. I'm trying my best. So one of the things that I can do to do that is, because the lighting is almost what I want as well, it's not exactly like, what I can do then is I can do an extra layer and I can set it up to luminosity, and what happens then is I can color pick of this one and it will pick the right light. And you see here that the light is actually brighter here, but that's kind of good because I need it to be brighter. The colors are staying the same. So it's kind of helpful. So, it gets around here is gonna vanish because it's gonna be in shadow. So, and I'm doing this one is on a different layer than this little black piece here, because I need to. I knew I needed to paint under it. So I already knew that I was gonna have to do stuff there. Multitasking is good. So the point is. So when leaving the app, the music vanishes, however very stable. Okay, it's a shame that the music vanishes though when you go out of the app. But on the other hand, you know, Facebook really needs to fix up their app. It's just, right now, it's not really doable to do anything through it. Hopefully it's something that they're keeping in mind. So I'm basically just adding some randomness here. And let's see here. So she has. I'm gonna explain now a bit. I have this shadow going on here. That's because she, the hair I'm gonna use is the one that's used for Khutulun in the Netflix series Marco Polo, and she has these really long braids that go down, and they're differently long. I'm gonna take out another one. I have another reference for that one. It's darker, but I think it's better. Yeah. So we're gonna remove this one. She has a braid that comes down here that has a little thingy on it, and she has a braid that comes down here that stretches longer. So I'm gonna have her to have two braids as well. But I'm probably gonna have a longer braid here and a shorter braid is gonna stop here somewhere. to give a little oomph to it. Oh, excuse me. Alright, cool. That's really cool. I'll just show on the how the app looks through the phone. That was quite cool, actually. Looking good. So in any case, so she needs to have that one come down there. And you can have. She has a little bit of bangs as well. And I think eventually I will give her that one here as well. Because it looks a little bit more like she's, you know, ready to go. And that's kind of the point. She's posing. These ones are very much posing images. But I want her to be displaying as ready to go at any moment. Slightly less colorful over here in the shadow, and I need to make sure that this one sits proper as well. So I'm making this stretch out further now than it's actually going to show later.
But, you know.
One image. Yes, I'm completely distracted. No, it's not like that. It's not like that. I get pinged as well. People ping me. Like they write something and post on Facebook, and there's a loss of keeping an eye on Facebook. It's Right, so that's that, and then we need to have something like this over here. It's darker, but still functioning. It's gonna be a lot darker down there. But this is where it actually helped to have that one. So, just make it happen. Now I'm gonna be starting to go back and forth with everything. Just to really, really move everywhere. Make some noise, make some gold. They're stealing colors because they work within the spec of what I want. some bling bling. Garuda, no, I'm not sure about Garuda actually. We'll see. Right now I'm focusing on adding Mongolian things. And then when I'm getting to the, I'm gonna have some red accents, then I'm gonna be mainly Chinese stuff. But, you know, we'll see. We'll see what we can get out of it. Just adding some stuff that kind of feels like the right thing to have. So again here, that's where there will be shadow. Like that. Like to have those. Let's see what happens if we merge this one down. Ah, yeah, good, awesome. So then we want to have some of these kind of ball thingies here, because that's what I really liked about that one. So let's see if we have anything. Nothing really there. Let's look if we have not there. Maybe on her. Those one might work actually. This might work. So I'm just looking for specific colors now, really. That's what I'm looking for. And to use those colors to add that sensation of realism. So to do that one, where I need to look for. Down. And move this one down here so I can see how it looks. Yes. So that's that one. Now what I just look for a proper shiny thing. Do I have a proper shiny thing? Metal. Which is suiting. Oh yeah, here we go. This one might work. This one we'll just do clockwise, and that kind of gives us the right. So what I'm looking for here is not particularly all the scratches and chisel. It's actually more about the light and the color that hits it. So we're just need to get the right, the first one right first. First one right first. And then once that one is done, I can just remove this one and go completely without it. Right. Not super. Something like that. With a heavy highlight. Where the light is coming from, which would be on the top side there. And a little bit of a reflection from the gold. And I can remove this one. I don't need it anymore. So now, I can be very lazy And I can just duplicate this one and move it around. I may make it smaller, a little bit smaller. And we just move it further away. So duplicate layer again, and then we're gonna just change it like so, just a little bit, a tad. Let me just flip it over here. This one needs to be lowered in opacity a little bit. Actually, I need to change this one slightly more. Something like that. It's on the right track, but not close, but no banana is the word I think I'm looking for. This one can go down, and this one can be duplicated again, just to now I'm just gonna duplicate these ones and make them sit to the right spots. This one's smaller. It's gonna look better. Transform again. Yes. Duplicate. Merge those ones. Red copper might give a contrast. Yes, it might actually. Are you thinking like on the balls then, or on the thingies? On the balls. Excuse me. I want to keep these ones black. I want to have other accents in red, but a red copper instead of gold. Nah, that's not gonna happen. I understand what you mean, but it's, you know, they have gold. It's one of those things that it's gonna be difficult for me to change and keep the feel of. White scars intact. They're not gonna feel like white scars anymore. Otherwise, it's a good idea. It's a really good idea. Yes, red copper Chinese steel cells is a really good idea. I like that one. I really like that idea. Duplicate and lots of duplication here. So,
it's time to march or die. Bear the right to work. As the race will begin, it may all less that state. Reads a hard piece of pain, stirs the blood, mind of the mass.
Sometimes lots of duplication because I'm just, you know, putting out these spots here. But then we're gonna merge all of those ones. We're gonna move them slightly, change the way they look slightly, because it needs to. Better. So, like that. It's better white. Let's stable. So so what you did was then you downloaded the app onto your phone then. That's kind of cool. I didn't know. I knew that they had an app, but you know, I wasn't aware of if it was good or not. And there's no lag at all. Okay, so if I'm gonna type something now, and you tell me how long it takes before my, and then I'll say a number. Six. And you type when you see, when you hear me say the number. No lag at all. Oh, cool. That's awesome. Okay, you typed six quite late though. That was maybe it's late on my side. The color, I'm gonna change the color slightly. When it gets curved away from the light from above, it's gonna get slightly less yellow. As well. Ah, you dropped the phone. Don't do that one, it's not good. I'm just gonna add some colors onto this. Onto this armor. The sensation about where we're gonna have all the color. I'm not stressing you anymore. I'm sorry. I don't mean to stress you. You know that one. If I would mean to stress you, I would be saying weird ass shit. Alright, so in any case, now, are you happy with this? Maybe see if we can add this one. This color to the shadow here. It's a bit less pale, a bit less more color to that one. But that's fine. So then I can remove this one. Let's remove that one. Yes, those ones. I do not want to use those ones. I had another one, another piece of. Armor. Yes, there will be metal heads later. Pun completely intended. This is kind of cool armor. Oh, that's terribly small. The burn I'm gonna use, yeah, I was pondering about that one. I think I'm gonna be using just a straight up, that didn't help, not, sorry. I think I'm gonna use a straight up eagle, actually, to be quite honest. I collected some eagle references here earlier. Right now I'm just looking at, I like these bands here as well, but I'm not gonna use those ones. I have a couple of references. This is, someone made some weird ass alien bird. I'm not gonna use this one, but it's these are basically the references I collected for this painting. All in all, lots of Mongolians. Some white people. This one I need to incorporate somewhere. And there's gonna be I felt like the same images again twice. Okay. So yeah, I think eagle. But the question is which one. The ones I collected is just from a festival of eagles in Mongolia. And they have, oh, it's not just eagles, they have falcons and hawks and chisel. It's gonna be a bird of prey in any case, with two heads. And one of them being a mechanical one. So, as it looks, it's gonna be these ones anyway. I'm gonna use these ones anyway. So I wanted to make a band. An alien eagle. Yeah, well, it's gonna be kind of alien anyway, because it's gonna be semi-robotic. I'm not sure. I haven't made up my mind yet. These are things we can discuss later. Save quickly. Save as 13. Lucky 13. How many people do we have on here? Not many. One viewer. But we're all the Medi anyway. Capitals. The eagles are capital. Yeah, let's. I'm just gonna commit everything here now. Merge down. Yes. So we're gonna save as. It changed something. Not sure exactly what it changed. We'll see. I'm gonna do this one instead. I'm gonna select all, copy merged, paste. Since everything underneath there is gonna be that kind of color anyway. And then we can save it. Like so. Keeping the little balls and thingy there, so I can later fix that one, but not now. So now we're gonna add a bottom one. Let's see, what do we have? Do we have any images of the con? I have... I have one that's made by Nicholas. Which is interesting, but it's not really what I'm looking for. It's just for a general idea. This one is... So this one, on this one we can see how they have, how they add their red accents. So there's a lightning in the middle, they have red accents there. That's something we're gonna do as well. I'm not even gonna open this one up, I'm just checking where to. So we're gonna add a accent of red here. Okay, I need to fix this one. First we go here. Just take a look proper. So... What I'm doing right now is actually I'm checking how it lies, the armor, how the light is hitting, and where I need to change some of the lighting, because it's here I need to change the lighting because it's not following exactly how the armor would go. There, so we can see how to fix that one. That's gonna be fixed by adding a little bit more light here, darken it a little bit here, here, and here. Toning it down a little bit. Alright. TTFN. Fixing up the armor to make sure that it actually looks like it should. My arm should be stretching out here somewhat, but that's gonna be hardly seen, that's why it's very dark. I'm just gonna add temporary light of the same kind as before, because it needs to show that this is where the shoulder pad thing is. Flat end. so. And we'll stop. Stop pretty much directly there. To be kind behind the bird. So I'm just talking for myself now. If there's anyone who pops in and wants to talk, just talk. Talk. This is why we need you guys. Things out a little bit. Better. So at a later point I will be adding a a proper texture over that one, probably. We'll see. For now gonna move around. Let's see up there. Boom. So I'm looking for a reference now for just general for Space Marine figure. I have a big folder of Space Marines references from people, friends, Romans, countrymen, from online galleries and stuff like that. I just use these ones for references to give an idea on how the armor can move. And things like that. Right now I'm actually looking for something that will help me shape the chest of her armor better so that it actually looks a little bit more 40k, 30k ish than what I have right now. Where was I? So 40k-ish. It's more about a feeling for how the curves go. Then let's take this one. This is something that Diego made. Diego Gispel Lorenz is a colleague, I dare say friend, and he does some awesome works, but this one has the right feel to it ish, how the chest goes and stuff like that. So, in any case, what I wanted to do was mainly was to get that feel for how the chest is sitting. And it, you know, it needs to be armor. It doesn't need to be female armor, it needs to be armor. That's the important part. So that's what we're looking for. That one in the way. We have this one. Chest area is there. I wanna have a little ball here eventually. At the very least. Sure that this one goes the right way, so it needs to. This is what I was missing. This is why it was good that I took up Diego's work. So sometimes it's easy to miss these things, but it actually curves down over here. So, and the same goes for over here, where it actually curves down and it will end up. I'm just gonna make that one in. So now if you look at it now, I'm not sure I'm gonna keep that little ball thingy there. I'm probably gonna remove that one. It looks better. Not perfect. Eventually put our little accent here on the bottom part of this one. And that accent will be red, and it's not gonna be red like this one, but you know. Let's see, references. I have materials somewhere. So we have something red lacquer. This one might work. This one is good. That's gloss. I don't need the gloss, I need this one. See if I can find, another one that's equally good. That Chinese red thing going on. I'm gonna be doing this one for maximum 15 more minutes. Then eventually I will be sharing this one on Facebook, on YouTube. I'll also be sharing the preview of the image like I did yesterday, so you guys can share and like and so on. Right now I'm looking for red stuff. There we go. Might be slightly too... This might be slightly too much though. Well, it might work actually. Do we have... Okay. So, let's see what happens when we do a little bit of a overlay. And what happens normally is that it takes things down a little bit too much, and that's kind of what we want. Actually, it's good. This is good. So we need to. Flip the image clockwise. Light comes from the wrong direction. We need to come like so. And then I can actually use this one as a color reference, which is good. So I can stitch down, make a little bit better. Excuse me. And then I'm gonna start making this. Let's just do that one the old-fashioned way and see what gives. Shaky right now with this one. This is one of the reasons why I want to stop as well. I'm starting to get a bit tired after an entire day of this. Better. Important part is the bottom part here, so just make sure that we can and then we start adding, because we're on a new layer now, so I'm start adding the darkest of the dark here. That darkest of dark is still quite bright as it seems. But so at this point I'm gonna add gonna take a look at that other reference I had. somewhere. That one doesn't help. There. At this point, I'm gonna take a look at this one because this one can now be of interest. I've already made a decision on how and where and what to do. And it's a case of looking if there's anything I need to consider. Like for instance, there are interesting. How it works, how it goes. What gives, what I need to think about, what I need to keep in mind, what I need to put in the right place and so on and so forth. All in all, this actually looks to be quite close to what I want. Might have to do some color correction at a later time, but that's fine. They have some markings and chisel going on there. I'm gonna be using that one as well. So probably be looking up more Chinese stuff to add here. And then from these ones, we'll go copper. Copper features, because they're red and they're kind of cool, and I'm not sure if I had copper. I have copper probably somewhere. Ooh, I found an awesome this one. It's actually a little bit better because of the red and how it works. Save this one to my reference folder here, because that is very close to what I want. I can remove this one, don't need that one. So, let's not do that one. Almost made an empire. This means that it actually gets closer in color to what I want to do. Gets closer in the color range. It gets closer in the feel, in general feel of it. Plus, I have some gold features that I can use to bring in that sensation of copper, which is how I roll. So, little bit of a dent here to help that sensation of the fact that it's actually going around there. So that one is there. Need to you have that one here as well. So shadow in the beginning here. I've always had it quite easy with phases. You know, some phases take a long time to work out, but I kind of know what I want to do with them. And it's the other materials that causes me problems. So I'm gonna be doing slightly. I'm gonna be doing more. Some more tests and. Practice, I think.
All alone, the wax of God. Call the cats of justice done. All alone, the wax.
It will happen, it will be good.
Call the cats of justice done. All alone, the wax of God. Call the cats of justice done.
Okay. Now, to be able to get that dent feel, that's actually an object in space, a 3D object in space. We need to show that specular highlight that you have there. Then we add in some of these dents. Every place we put a dent, we can also put some more of that specular height highlight, and then I can work this one up later. When I'm, you know, getting more confident about what it is exactly that I'm gonna put here. For now, this one gives a very nice sensation of something. Ceramic-esque, and time to stop. So it's time to stop for today. I am very grateful for anyone who has been here watching during the time, and if you haven't been here watching during the time, I hope you were enjoying the videos when I start posting them. But this is me saying goodbye for today, and I'll see you guys next time, which would be on Friday. So have a nice day, enjoy tomorrow, and that's all.